talk a little bit about the moment that my psych attacked. So, to let's start, there's always like the denial. It will not happen to me. And like, it's not currently happening to me, and well, if it's done, well, it'll probably never happen. So, a little bit about the story. So, I have things set up, like, I believe my site is secure. Like, I have that difficult password. I have, like, VPN access to home before I can log in. So, it's like, really based on IP. If I'm not, like, here, then I first need to log in to my home to be able to log in as admin. Files cannot be changed. You can't install plugins or apps plugins. I even renamed the content folder, which is kind of like scary because people assume where the upload folder is. Other positive effects are like I wrote a lot of my code myself. What happened that code is not public, so people have no clue how it happened. I also have like PhD with Opcat, which means that the first time you visit the website, everything will be cached, all your PhD files. And when someone wants to change it, they also need to restart the machine to be able to get all those new files there. And I have a network install. So again, my upload folder has, it doesn't always mean that it's WP content slash uploads slash 2015. There's always like the site ID in between. And then it's all up for like having things up to date. And normally I have. Except that one plugin that, well, skipped my attention. And I didn't know that I didn't have it updated for a while. And at one point, I worked at a hosting company and got an email. Like a few hundred customers got hacked. It was this plugin. And well, I was like, well, I can check it out. Like, I know the plugin, like I used it myself, like so let's see if I can reproduce it. So I was playing along, checking things out, and I got like 200 response back, like something did happen. So I was checking out my site, like I log in my SAP and see what if something happened. And yes, I saw files uploaded to my upload directory. I was scanning along and I already saw that people were already trying that. Like, they were already uploading a lot of PHP files. So, yeah. You get like this place, like you're completely shocked, totally in denial, and you got this image again. Obviously, one option is, keep calm and well, nothing happened, right? So, because I'm a developer, I was like, well, let's talk to the log file and see how they manage that, like. So I check things down, and I see that they tried. But I also checked the files and I see they fail. Like I saw 404 because they assumed it was in a certain directory. And because it's network installed, that plugin was not enabled on the main site. So I could not ever found it unless they were like doing more stuff than basically script kiddie style, go to your website and do whatever they want. Like a lot of people, if you're a WordPress site, they assume you have a new line install. Check your log files, you will see stuff like that. So this was partly on what was in there. So the first item what you see is they try to upload something. The second one is they check if that file was there. And in this case, we're checking the content folder. My bad is that because I have a custom one and I want to be good for Google, I rewrote it by its name that it directly redirected the hacker to the right place. Again, the network install saved my ass that it was not in that directory. They should have added the site. Then after that, like you have the anger, like having heard that stupid rewrite. Like I could have deleted that. Like that site was already moved in this kind of infrastructure for like a year. I'm pretty sure Google already updated it. And then secondly, like why didn't I do update my plugin? Like my server is always up to date. It's really easy to go in, update it. And I trust my OS Debian to be always like tested really well and know what they're doing. But then again, it's like, why didn't I have like any protection in place? Like, because it's my own VPS, I don't have a host to protect me. Like, some hosts protect you by adding already those blocks. Like, when I was working at the host, like, we were already working on finding ways to secure all our customers who still did not have updated that plugin, and there were quite a few people. And then it's like, okay, working through, like, start fixing things, like, what did the hacker do? Like, go through your site, like, in this case, first of all, update that, finally, that one plugin that was a pain in the ass, that because of that, it could upload PC files. No moment that happens, well, you have zero clue what's going on. You, hackers can add, like, spam links, but they can also delete content or do things that probably can hurt your business in a bad way. After that, I was like checking upload folder for more PHP files, and I delete all the PHP files there, even the index of PHP, the blank ones. And I went to Nginx to also don't allow PHP execution anymore. There are plugins doing this for you, so you don't have to do it yourself. Especially in the case of most of your users, then it's really easy to do with Apache, what most hosts running on. So you can disinstall the plugin and get that block out. And I was still checking, like, everything is still in touch. Like, did they change PHP files? Did they add content? And for me, it was pretty easy. Like, I have everything in a repo, and all my code is there. So I can just do with one command, say, what is the differentiation? Like, did some people change some stuff, or files added or removed? But I was lucky because I have that. But what about you? So because of that, I now build it like code that helps the regular user to do this themselves. So what I build is like, I build like a whole service with an API that you can say, like, I have this plugin with this version. Please give me all the checksums. And checksums are like hashes. Like, they get all the code of your file and make it like one value of 32 letters or characters. And because, and those values you can compare on your machine if something got changed. You don't know what, but you do know something got changed somewhere. And so it's already a good guideline where they got changed. So now it's not only for WordPress, for Core, but also for plugins and teams. So currently I'm still in the building phase. So here's a URL for like an example of one of my plugins that goes to WP Central, which is my website, and I have this API for, in this case, for developers to build cool stuff that will help you out. Currently, it's still there in the building phase, but I believe in a month or two, we will see the first plugin using this API that you can install a plugin and see on the moment you got hacked what someone did. And obviously, when something like this happens, you start wondering, like, how could I prevent this from happening again? And it's something called like an application firewall. What it does is basically protect you against common attacks, like in this case, cross-site scripting and SQL injections, but it does way more. One of those companies that I personally like is Sucuri, who also sponsors or helps out WordPress in a really good way. And because of that, they also know WordPress really well. So on the moment there is like something going on, they probably already knew it before it was publicly announced, but they will check all the log files they generate from all the people they protect. And because parsing that log files on a weekly basis, they know exactly what is going on. It is expensive though. It starts like around $18 a month. If you want something cheap, then go for Cloudflare, which is also a really good company. But obviously they put security not directly on the first place, but security, that's their main business. For Cloudflare, it's more their second business. They are more like getting all the websites available all the time, like kind of CDN for your website. But if, for example, you want to do more on your own machine, then Ninja Firewall is a good way to go to. Personally, I would not use it because I already control the machines and I can figure out most of the things. The reason is that Ninja Firewall is PHP, but then again, if you're a shared host it, and you have not enough knowledge to do yourself, then Ninja Firewall is the way to go. Like, you can install it, depending on your host, it's a few clicks on the buttons and it works. Currently, I use more security, what is more for developer-specific people, because you need to write a lot of links yourself. Then again, there's a website with a lot of rule sets that you can use on OWASP.org. And there's like a lot of things about security there. Like, I was reading through and you see like a few posts about WordPress, how they think you can secure it. And then again, like, the moment you got hacked, like, how do you detect yourself? So today I show you a little pet project of myself that I custom built it, and it's based on WordPress, and it makes like always connection to my site. So what you see here is like, I have two websites currently in it. Like, I maintain a website of the Serbian community, and currently you see it's 4.3, and you see it's a red bar. If I update it to 4.3.1, the next moment it will check it again, it will be green again. So this way I exactly know when something is not up to date. You will see the team updates, login updates, if it's on Git or Xen, I know exactly where the repo is. So if something is up and I need to fix it, and I don't have it already on my machine, I can go to it and fix it. So if you go down back here, you see the same again, and I have wrote down some to-dos like, well, if I want to update directly the plugin or theme from here, like, how can I do that? Like, if I want to release this as some public tool, like, people probably want to use this also to update their plugin or theme, like, ManageWP with WP Remote, those kind of tools can do it, but then maybe in a different way, like, maybe you can extend things with plugins. For example, if you want to update a rebit plugin, Jetpack, Joe's SEO, but those things are so tight in your website, you want to be sure it works. So you can build, someone like me, a developer, can build like tools that checks your website for you. So when the moment you press update, you already check roughly if your website has changed. So you can make screenshots, compare them, you can see if the website is still returning responses on random pages. And if developers can build that, then it would really help like tools like this for your website security, because plugins in general are a really good start. But if I find your password, I can disable those plugins and I can do whatever you want, and you lose track of what is going on your website. Probably the moment you go to your plugin page, you will see they are deactivated. But how many people look at that plugin page, like on even on a weekly level? Like, I'm not even talking about daily anymore. I never do that. Like, the only time I look at it is when I want to activate a plugin on a certain website or deactivate. And then I build like a check. So currently, I'm not sure what was going on with when I built the screen. So I check something in WordPress. If there is a response, I will get it a year back. I work like, because I have a Git website, I'm working also to build like a check-in that it will see what is the difference, so I can get it already here. All by saving time. How much data I have on my laptop, the more time I have to look at it and train without internet connection. And I'm also looking at adding and missing files. So this was something I built. So what you see here really badly is that I have a list of a lot of plugins, especially on the REST API, I downloaded it from here and I put it on. So obviously there are changes, and it will list that a lot of those files, like a README and some controls, are not the same as they are from WordPress. So this is a really good indicator that probably something is going on. Another check that I'm working on is checking the upload directory, scanning PHP files, if there are, see why they are there, and show you that which files are there, so you can see yourself and make a good guess if that belongs there or not. But I even went a step further, like, I run my own server, so I probably need to maintain those too. Like, there are really good tools out there for people like me and like developers that like maintaining servers. But it's like, well, probably you also maybe want to, like, even if you're like a user, like, you want to know what is your hosting up to. Like, do you have like the latest beta version or not? So what I built here is like, it will list things down by, let me go. So, so here you have that list. Thank you. I'm sorry. So here you see a list again with like, on my old site that is still there, there's quite a lot of updates still there. Like, I have some basic server updates that I need to do. I use for my images that get handled not by PHP, but by a library called Graphic Magic. And I see that I still need things to do. But if I look down back here, I see on this my current one, that I'm running P67, I run the latest version of NGINX, I run the latest version of Debian, and there are no updates. So without going into the machine, and if I have like 10 customers, and I don't need to look at all those 10, even from people, like the regular users, they generally have like not one hosting contract, they have way more. And then it's always like, well, accept that it happened, and hope probably that it never happened again. Like, I made some steps, I learned from my mistakes, and there are like things like, don't expect like plugin developers to say like, well, I fixed a security issue and you should write update. Like, some people like think it's a bad thing. Like, if there's a security update, you should scream it out of the rules. Like, please people, update. Don't tell them how you can reproduce it, because on the moment you do that, people will find out what to do. Like, find ways to read log files, even if you don't understand them. Like, I hardly understand them. Understand them, it's like reading through. It's like, you need to find the time. Because of that, I was reading just, I saw the request. Like, I know how people request my website, and because of that, with some basic knowledge, I could see why the heck I did that and find ways to reproduce it. Like, Before I was working for a hosting company, I had zero clue about my security, and because they were using it, I started looking at, like, what does that do for my website? Like, how can I learn from that? And because I know how to build the tools, I'm more proactive in seeing what is going on in my website, see what someone tries to do. And if I want to go a step further, I can even parse log files by an open source project from Sucuri. They released, one of the founders released an open source variant of parsing log files to see what people are doing. Again, it's probably for most people a step before, even for me, but it's out there. So when you have time, you can play and see, can I set it up, can I parse it? And that's what I'm currently doing. Like, I'm checking out online to see what people are saying about security. I don't have to understand it, but I know if I can improve. And in the end, that's all what's going on. Like, you have a website. You should trust your website, but you should not trust per se that the host and everyone else will do all their effort to protect your website. In the end, if you are at the big host, you're one of the 1 million customers. Can you expect that they are going to pay for you? Like, in general, the bigger hosts have security scanners in place. They have like an abuse team that on a regular basis, check things out and see for like the bigger hacks. And in this case, you have 400 customers. But if you are one customer who got hacked with that one not so popular plugin, you should know about that. So, last but not least, some questions for you. Like, do you know what your hosts do to protect you? Like, what do you do even yourself? Like, do you have like a plugin enabled to protect you, to give notifications, or whatever it can do for you? How good is your WP login protector? Like, how good is your username and password? But also, if someone is trying to protect your credentials, is there some blocking mechanism? Again, a lot of hosting companies do block you, block the attacker for getting in. But then again, a lot of attackers have like an IP pool of a million, or not a million, but thousands of IPs. If the hosting company takes an IP, they have 1,000 times 3 the chance to get the password on a given hour or day, depending on how they protect. What do you do for hardening your site? Like, there is a website, an entry on the Codex of WordPress that shows you how you can do little steps, like disabling the editor, enabling plugins through WordPress, finding ways to do that. Again, what I did not say that I brought my WP login with Ajax, so that basically you have to fill in password first to get into WP admin. Personally, I don't like that. If they want to hurt me, they will do a little protect anyway, so I rather protect through PHP on base level. Like, if I'm an admin or a super admin or even an editor, that those people have use IP checks, but if then, like, if they're like a regular person just can log in, I'd rather have them log in and see what happens. And then again, like, how secure are your backups? Like, do you have a backup of your site on your machine? Or do you solely trust your hosting company to always have backups? And if your site got hacked or something happens, how fast do you think your host can get a backup of you? Like, try it out. Like, ask for a backup because, well, you need it. And see how the host will respond to your request. And do you know what even people try now? Like, again, the log files. Do you check them out, or do you know exactly if you saw some weirdness but never looked it up? I'm Mark Heijnen. I'm the founder of Code Kitchen. I'm the lead developer of WordPress, where Translator WordPress.org is built on. I am a long-time contributor to WordPress, and I'm one of the organizers of WordCamp Belgrade. Thank you for listening.
So do we have security questions? Right there.
Would you say that using Git is mandatory? That really helps debug your security?
So the question is if Git is mandatory. I would not particularly security, not directly, but then again, like if someone did try to change my website, I can with one command I can see Git this. Or get status, see which files are added, what has got changed. So it's not per se that it's needed, but it's a really good thing to do. Like saying that I have network installation. It's a little bit more tricky to maintain, but because of that, the script kiddies who attack your website, like the basic attacks, they don't check that. So having the differentiation in your website is always a good thing to do, and having Git and making it more easier. Like if you say, like, for example, with SiteGround, I can commit stuff locally, and it's already there. I'm not sure if those go there to do the same now, or if they're working. So there are some hosts doing that. Like, you can already use Git on your machine. When you commit to master branch, that it's already there, which means why should you have the feature of adding plugins or teams through your WordPress website? So the moment someone can't find your password, they can't install anything. They can't edit anything from the UI. So they really need to find a way to add the PC file or the hack to a different way.
Thank you, Marco. Great talk. Let's be honest. What do you think? How many people in this room are actually capable of, you know, administering their own servers and actually, you know, doing everything you just said and making sure their site is secure? Is it really something that, you know, everyone should learn, or is it something, you know, you should be aware of?
It's aware of, you should know what's going on. And to be honest, I was not capable to even contribute back to WordPress a few years ago. Like when I started with 3.0, I did some stuff, like, but in 3.5, I rewrote image manipulation API in WordPress. During that time when I was doing that, it was like hitting my head on the table a few times. So it's more about knowing that it's there, and just, even if it's putting like 30 minutes of your time or an hour of your time reading through online how you can protect your website in a better way. Like, if you never use the editor of plugins and themes, it's one line in your config file and you can disable that. So it's more showing more interest what is going out there in the world, and be clear that running your website 5 years ago is completely different than now. Now people are more eager to hack your website because WordPress is getting more popular, and WordPress is the main site, our main tool to attack. Doesn't mean that WordPress is insecure, but it does mean it's a pretty good target.
What about backups? Wouldn't it be easier to start from a previous backup than to start from an infected setup?
Yes, but the problem is, do you know that your backup is not infected? So, for example, some tools and some hosts even backup your site on the same distance. Means if your hacker can find a way to get to your website, they know how to find a way, if they really want to break, how to find a way to the backend. So that's the more tricky part. Ah, let's see then.
As I am probably not so strong than you on the technical side, I prefer to use a WP engine, for instance, and to have backups made automatically, and to go to their team for them to help me. And they are also superior as a second level. And for people like me, it's perhaps easier than to do all the technical things that you do on your own side, and subscribe or so on for the other person in the room.
Correct. So, for example, automatic with Jetpack, you also have like WordPress. That one also makes backups, but they also, after that, they also do security checks and will clean things up for you. So there are really good services. I don't know the one you mentioned, but yes, if you have like a service, again, the same with security for protecting it, but then they do it for backups and they will also check your backups if there are like irregularities, things have changed or got hacked, and they will clean it up and will notify you. So for probably most people here, like their users, it's a really good thing to have in the
Great, thank you so much, Marco.
Thank you.